volume stress, also called here bulk stress or hydraulic stress. See, to understand this, let us consider a body is completely immersed in a fluid, suppose in water or in a liquid. Then what happens? Suppose it is a container. In container we contain some liquid here. Now any object is immersed in it, like this shape. Actually, what happens here? Now whenever an object is completely immersed in liquid, then what happens here? This water or liquid exerts force in all directions on the body perpendicular to the surface. At every point the liquid exerts force perpendicular to the surface. So that we may observe there is contraction in volume of the body, a little bit contraction, now this much is the contraction in the volume of the body, but without change in the shape. Size is decreased but shape could not change. So here, how do you calculate the volume stress exerted by the liquid? Here the volume stress again calculated by the formula. Suppose all over the surface total force applied is F is the total force applied by the liquid all over the surface, on the entire surface, and total surface area of the body is A. So that the volume stress is again calculated by the formula, force by area. Now this is equal to the pressure exerted by the liquid. So that the volume stress is nothing but the volume stress, bulk stress or hydraulic stress is nothing but pressure. The hydraulic stress exerted by any fluid is equal to pressure, that is P. Here again it is calculated in units. We know the units, SI units, Newton per meter square. For pressure we have a unit that is Pascal, symbol is PA. Okay, so it is also normal stress. Like this, we are having two types of normal stress, longitudinal stress and volume stress. Thereafter we go for tangential or shearing stress.